So, who are we here with?
Itsy Sweeney.
And where are you from?
Pennsylvania, Pocono area.
And if you want to give us a quick little rundown of your health journey and how you came to wind up at a Woodstock Fruit Festival eating a copious amount of fruit.
It's a long journey. Well, back in 1996, I started feeling just being in pain from a lot of basic, simple things, and I couldn't figure it out. And by the year 1998, I was just unable to function in a lot of ways, and I just basically thought I had Lyme disease because I was a park ranger and I had pulled a lot of ticks off me. And it turns out it was Lyme disease, but it wasn't diagnosed for 4 years. So basically, I got sicker and sicker and sicker to the point where I couldn't find my way home from work and I could barely make it up my stairs, and it was pretty rough. And I did get treated for Lyme, which really helped a lot, which kind of saved my life. And it kind of gave me enough strength to start functioning a little better on my own. And I was reading a lot. They actually called it fibromyalgia because I was in so much pain. So for fibromyalgia, I started studying up on what would be the best way to get rid of fibro. So basically, I went vegetarian, and it helped, but not completely. Then I found that if I went vegan, I would feel a little better yet. So I pretty much did that. And then still not completely, but mostly vegan. And it did make a difference, but I still had the chronic fatigue, and I still had pretty much chronic mono. With, you know, if I'd get tested for mono, it was like always positive, which, you know, it's just tiring. You just feel like you have the flu all the time. And even though you might look healthy, you feel really crappy, and it's rough, you know. But then I'm reading more and more about raw foods, and I'm thinking, boy, can I just continue on this journey and really be extreme? Because most people thought I was extreme being vegetarian than vegan. But I'm doing it, and I've been eating raw for, not completely raw, about 80, 85% raw for the last year and a half or so. And it's been helping. I mean, I have these bursts of energy. I still have to take naps during the day, but I have these bursts of energy that are like the old me, and it feels really good. And it's almost emotional talking about it because I forgot what I was like before I got sick. So it's nice and it's good, and I feel like I'm on the right path because I always ask for guidance. I just kind of pray to God, show me the way, I want to get better, you know. So I'm on the path, you know. And even though it seems extreme, I think the way I ate before and the way I lived my life before, that was what was extreme. So you could say eating fruits and vegetables is extreme, but it's nothing compared to eating processed foods and GMO foods and unhealthy dairy that just clogs up your body and just makes you feel so crappy and heavy. I feel lighter. And I'm not saying I'm completely there, and I know I will be there one day. And it's every little bit that I do counts. And the raw foods has brought me really in a whole direction that I love. I feel like it's right. I'm on the right path. And being here with all these other raw foodists and seeing all these vibrant, healthy people makes me want to do it more. And seeing people here who've been doing it for 15 years, for 17 and 20, and even I think there's a 30-year raw vegan here. And to me, he's the picture of health. And that's what I want for myself. So it's exciting. I'm going to keep on the journey, and I'm just as happy as I can be to be here. I'm learning so much every day. I feel good, and I love the energy. I love the energy of everyone here. It means a lot to me, absolutely a lot.